Hello students, today we are going to learn lesson of 4th standard subject Environmental Studies. Our lesson name is Management of the Welfare State of Swaraj. Students, we already learned in previous lessons, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj struggled long against many unjust powers. They were the Aldijahi, Mughal powers, the Portuguese and the Siddhis of Janjira. That is how an independent Hindvi Swaraj was created. For smooth working, Shivaji Maharaj divided the administration into 8 departments. He appointed a minister in charge of each. This was his famous council of 8 ministers. The Swaraj of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was a state run for the welfare of the people. In the true sense of the term, it was run with the assistance of the 8 ministers. Shivaji Maharaj himself made the appointments of these 8 ministers and other important officers on the basis of their eligibility and merit. He supervised all their work. Students, the Council of 8 Ministers chart is given here. In this chart, we studied name of the minister and its designation and which department he handled. We see one by one. First one is Moro Trimbak Pingle. His designation is Pradhan and its department is Administration. Second, Ramchandra Nilkantha Muzumdar. His designation is Amatya and department is Revenue and Accounts of the State. Third one, Hambir Rao Mohite. He is Senapati and department Defense. Fourth, Moreshwar Pandit Rao. His designation is Pandit Rao. His department is Religious Matters. Fifth one, Niraji Rao Ji. His designation is Nyayadhish. His department is Justice. Name of ministers. Sixth, Annaji Datto. Designation is Sachiv and department Government Orders. Seventh, Dattaji Trimbak Vaknis. His designation Mantri and department Correspondence. And last one, Ramchandra Timbak Dabir, designation Sumant and department Foreign Relations. Students, you must have to learn and remember the Council of 8 Ministers because many questions in your exam based on it and in competitive exam also. So you learn it carefully. Do you know, students, food, clothing and shelter are the basic necessities of the life. In a welfare state, these needs of people are satisfied. Women are honored, common people, peasants are not deceived. Injustice is not done to anyone. Justice is dispensed quickly. Agriculture and industries develop well. Whole cards flourish. People can live a happy, contented life. People lived happily in the Swaraj created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, the qualities of confidence, self-respect and patriotism strongly emerge among the people of Maharashtra. Students, here is something for you to do. Copy the royal edict for the section of environment given in your textbook. In big and beautiful letters, make a chart, read it aloud in the classroom. Now, the next topic and Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's next management skill is protection of environment. Natural environment includes land in nature, as also factors like air, rain, rivers and streams, seas, forests, the birds and animals, light received from the sun, moon, etc. It is beneficial for man to make use of this environment only to meet these necessities. Shivaji Maharaj took precautions to avoid the destruction of these environmental factors. Shivaji Maharaj saw to it that the forest in his kingdom would not be destroyed by the people. From the royal edict, we can see that he had issued many orders like the following. For the navy, it is necessary to build boats and ships of various sizes and their beams, masts, oars, etc. for which wood is required. To obtain this wood, only teak trees should be cut. If more teak wood is required, it should be purchased from the foreign territories. But on no account should mango, jackfruit or other trees be cut. They don't grow in a year or two. People look after them like their own children in order to grow them. Cutting them is to inflict sorrow on the people. It should not be done even when a tree is greatly worn out. It should be cut only after paying the owner and getting his consent. Students, always remember, World Environment Day is celebrated every year on 5th June to emphasize the importance of conserving and protecting the environment. Now, the water management. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj had various barns built near the village in Swaraj to make drinking water available to the people. Canals were dug out to make water available for agriculture. Due to this, there was an increase in the produce. People in Swaraj never felt the severity of droughts. During the regime of Shivaji Maharaj, the number of people living on fort was quite large. Shivaji Maharaj took care to make proper arrangement for water on the forts. Before building a fort, the place was inspected to see whether enough water was there. In case it didn't have water, tanks and reservoirs were built there before the onset of the rainy season, and rainwater was stored in them. The stored water was used economically. Due to such water management, people on the forts and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer from shortage of water even during drought periods. Students, can you tell why should we use water economically? Name a dam or lake situated near your village or locality. What is water management? What are the government schemes for water management? Students, think on these questions and try to get answers of these. Do you know, students? Our government has started a project Jal Yukta Shiva to make Maharashtra a drought-free state. Now the next topic is drought relief. Shivaji Maharaj gave various facilities to drought-affected peasants. He used wife taxes to severity of drought was reduced for people in Swaraj. In drought years, Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grain stores in the state granaries free of cost to the people. He also undertook repairs of various forts and construction of dams, burns and canals during drought years. This way, peasants and artisans or balutedas could earn their daily living and did not feel the severity of drought. As the peasants become wealthy, he could afford to buy things like footwear, clothes, etc. This provided work to artisans. Those who were homeless till then developed the capacity to build their own houses. This in turn provided work to the masons, the carpenters, the blacksmith, the brickmakers. This is how, along with the peasants in Swaraj, artisans also become happy and wealthy. Now the next topic is sea trade and other markets. Shivaji Maharaj raised his own independent navy in order to protect his Swaraj wealth and to establish his rule over the sea adjoining Swaraj. But that was not all. He also had special cargo ships built to promote trade in Swaraj. He developed trade ports like Rajapur. He built a special market on Raigad. He started a separate marketplace at Khed Shivapur near Pune. He developed marketplaces in big towns and roadside villages. A new pet of settlements was established as Pashan near Pune by the order of Veer Mata Jizabai. It was referred to as Jizapur. Shivaji Maharaj levied more taxes on goods imported from the outside regions to promote trade within Swaraj. He levied more tax on the salt produce in the Portuguese territory, which made it costlier. On the other hand, he reduced the taxes on the salt produce in Swaraj so that people could buy it at a cheaper rate. Naturally, it led to an increase the trade of salt produce in Swaraj. Thus, local trade was encouraged. Shivaji Maharaj made efforts for the growth of trade and industries in Swaraj. He personally made sure that his subjects could not be cheated by the merchants in any way. When he came to know that people are being cheated in the coconut and betel nut trade in Kokan, he won the subedar of that region. Now the next, high regard for women. Shivaji Maharaj had ordered that the women and children in the enemy camp were not be harmed in any way during the period of war. In fact, they were to be treated with great respect. The behavior of Shivaji Maharaj on several occasions set the ideal of how women were to be treated. The Maratha army had marched upon Belvandi in Karnataka to vanquish the fortress there. Mallamma Desai is a brave woman, fought a great battle in defense of the fortress. When Shivaji Maharaj came to know about her courage, he called her his younger sister, returned her fortress and villages to her with honor and gave her the title Savitri. Our next topic is vigilance regarding cleanliness. During the regime of Shivaji Maharaj, measures were taken to maintain better cleanliness in homes and in public places. He issued orders telling people to make a fence of the Nirgudi brush around the house to prevent the entry of animals like mice, scorpions, insects and ants. Fumigation was also suggested to destroy the germs that are harmful to health. People were warned not to leave garbage lying on the roads and markets on the foot. If garbage piled up in various places, in spite of all these, it was not to be thrown down the foot. It was to be burnt on the spot, and the ashes were to be used as manure for vegetables grown in backyards. Shivaji Maharaj's management of forts, guns and firearms, his navy, protection of the environment, water management, sea trade, market cleanliness and hygiene is a guiding force for us even today. Now the Hindvi Swaraj. Hindvi Swaraj was a dream of Shivaji Maharaj. Anyone who lived in Hinduism, no matter to what religion or community they belonged, was a Hindvi, and their Swaraj was Hindvi Swaraj. Now the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, religious tolerance. The religious policy of Shivaji Maharaj was liberal. In his campaigns, he never caused any harm to mosques. If he came across a copy of the Quran Sharif, he would respectfully pass it on to the Muslims. He never hated Muslims simply because they were Muslims. If a person who had changed his religion wished to return to his original religion, Shivaji Maharaj always helped him. His brother-in-law, Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar, was in the service of Adil Shah of Bijapur. Adil Shah made him aspect the Muslim faith. Bajaji made the Bijapur his home. He lacked for the nothing, but he was unhappy that he had changed his religion. One day he made up his mind to come back to his own religion. Shivaji Maharaj welcomed him back in his religion. The story of Netaji Palkar is similar. His religion had been changed, but he wished to return to his original faith. Shivaji Maharaj accepted him back into his religion.
Do you know, children? Shivaji Maharaj had great respect for sons and holy men. He honored temples. He also gave protection to masjids. He respected both the Bhagavad Gita and the Quran Sharif. He gave protection to Christian churches also. He honored learned men, Paramanand, Gaga Bhat, Dhundiraj, Bhushan and other learned men received his patronage. He bestowed great honor on Sant Tukaram, Samarth Ramdas, Baba Yakut and Mauni Baba.
Students remember him as a torchbearer in the dark light of slavery, a fighter who got a better of all difficult situations, who slowly but surely increased his strength while giving fight to powerful enemies, who encouraged his comrades and fooled his opponents and in the end achieved his goal. He was a model son, a cautious leader, a skilled organizer, benevolent administrator, a clear military strategist, a great warrior, a terror to weak, a defender of the good and the epoch maker. When one see all these brilliant facets of his personality, one cannot but say to oneself, bring to memory his wonderful image and remember his great achievements. Students, I hope you understand this lesson. Then share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel Easy Learning with Shashipriya. Thank you.